I had to dry off my face a little bit. I'm talking about the BB cream. We are launching tomorrow, ladies. This is quite incredible. And it's really a milestone for me. It's really a milestone to complete my line. Even though it is in the beginning of 2024, I wanted it to be in December of 2023, but had a little bit of a different reaction when I was talking to you about this. It really kind of surprised me. So I hope you enjoy this video. I hope you enjoy the BB cream that is finally here. And ladies, let's get this beauty started. All right, ladies, I have prepped my face. I've done my eyes. I have Sweet Carol on with plum eyeliner, my volume up mascara, and I have my Peter Thomas Roth vitamin C eye patches on because my eyes were puffy. And I have this little welt that decided to pop up today, which I thought, you know what? This is actually great. We're gonna be talking about BB cream. BB cream is here. Like, I literally went to the warehouse and I hugged the palette. I know, so silly, but yet so needed. I was just thinking to myself, I just want you to be in my warehouse. I just was thrilled. I didn't care. I was like, I'm so happy you're here, because I've showed you in my videos that I almost was at the point where I'm going to have to cut it, but I don't have to now because I have my new BB creams. I'm going to show you all four colors that we have. I'm going to go into the ingredients and why I created what I created. And it's been just really a journey with this BB cream. I mean, so stressful and just worth it. It's just totally worth it. I know that you're really excited about it as I am. And I know you're really tired of me saying it's coming. Oh no, it's next month. Oh, this and that. We've just had a lot of special drama with this product. So I have on my eyes, we're going to do complexion first. I'm going to, obviously I have to use my color corrector because we're dealing with, I don't know what is going on with my skin. I mean, it's very interesting. So I'm going to put my hair back so you can see the full face in action. Now, I have a blemish here, which is unusual. And then I have one underneath here, which is, I know that this is all hormones. It's my perimenopause action happening. Not really thrilled about it, but you know what? It is what it is. We roll with it. We work with it. We just embrace it and we say, okay, I know how to make it better. So let's go in with our color corrector, Just Peachy, because I would never take my concealer out, no matter what concealer I'm using, and say, oh yeah, you need to basically cover all of this. And that's, you know, I'm not going to give you any help. When you use a color corrector, you're helping your skin, especially if you're a mature woman. Like, you're basically saying, okay, let me correct the color first. Let me neutralize it out. And then let me put my concealer on, right? So your concealer doesn't have to work that hard. So you can already see by putting on this peach color, it's going to brighten and lighten. So all underneath here, I have this pigmentation. So I'm coming down. You do you. You can do it whatever way your skin dictates you to do it. For me, this works. I have to come down into like a little V like this, and I bring it up because I'm lifting my face. Inside this inner corner, blues, grays, not cute. You miss it. So you do a beautiful look. You do your eyes, you do your face, and then you have this darkness in here. I see it all the time on ladies. They completely forget to go into that corner. The nose shadowing, the darkness, the grays. It's just, it's what happens when you age. Now I'm taking my buffing foundation buffing brush, and I'm going to go right in to the area. I can buff it out. I can stipple it, basically just pushing it into the skin. Now, I didn't mention that I did do a nice prepping of my skin. Let me tell you what I used. I used the Noble Panacea Vitamin C Booster. Then I went over it with my Matter of Fact. That's the name of the brand. I always think it's funny when I say that because I'm not saying Matter of Fact, I'm saying the brand name. Matter of Fact, Minimalist Hydrating Moisturizer. So I put that on. It's nice and lightweight. So I have that. I didn't put on an eye cream, actually. I didn't feel like I needed it. And then I had those Peter Thomas Roth patches on. So I felt like I got that hydration I needed. And I'm just going to go in and just buff this all out. Before I move on to the concealer, I'm going to show you on my face the four colors that I have. Now, again, I'm a small beauty brand. I can't come out with 20 different colors, nor would I come out with 20 different colors for a BB cream. BB creams are more forgiving. You have more range when it comes to a BB cream, which stands for beauty balm. And in my case, it's a beauty blur. It's gonna blur the skin. This is going to be so beautiful for mature skin. And we're gonna get into the ingredients that I have formulated. But first we're going to do the fair. I'm gonna show you what the fair looks like. And then we're going to go into each one. So this is the lightest. I made it with a pink undertone. So it's going to be more of that cool neutral with that pink undertone, which is my first color. My second color is going to be light. This is the one that I've been showing you that I use all the time, is the light. So you can see that I have a rosy base to this, and this is more of a cool neutral with more of that in between. It's not super cool, it's not super warm. Then I have my light medium, and you're going to see, I always leave like just a little room for the last color. So this is light medium. This is if like you're in between, you have a little bit more warmer tone. You definitely like to get a little color, or you want to warm up the skin. And then I have tan, the very end. And you know what, let me put it right here. You have tan. So you're not going to go deep, deep yet. I want feedback on our colors because we had four original colors that were very yellow based, and I wanted to bring out a little bit more of a realistic range for us. So this is what we have that you can see on the skin. You can mix and match. You can mix, a lot of the ladies would mix the fair and the light last time in my original formula. You might not need to do this now. So you have this kind of range going on that is just very easy to work with. Now, let me, since I didn't do any of my no redness, let me do my no redness color corrector in the areas that I like, especially with this blemish up here. And I like to just do a little work in with my finger. No redness is in. I like using my finger because I, around the nose, it's harder with the brush to really get it. So I just like to press it in there. Now I'm gonna go in with my concealer. I would never try to make my concealer work that hard and think that it's going to cover everything if I have a lot of redness or pigmentation or darkness or what have you. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my creamy concealer and I'm going to just go over the areas. Really, it's this area here, and then I come down a little bit. It just depends, every day is different, but I love this creaminess, that it's not too heavy, not too light. This is really hydrating for the skin, and it's wonderful for mature skin. Again, you have to prep your face properly. You have to be using skincare. Again, you can't just use a product and not prep the skin if it's dry, dehydrated, and then you're putting on a concealer thinking like miracles are gonna happen. Start with your skin, that's the canvas, and then basically prep it properly, then be able to use your concealer. Concealer is on, looking beautiful. Very, very excited about the combo and what it does to my skin, and just looking really pretty and not kind of dulled down or anything. It still has that beautiful kind of hydration to it underneath the eyes. Now I'm going to show you, I'm going to be using light. So I'm going to use my BB cream like I usually do. I'm going to be telling you about my formulation. Now the whole bottle is pretty much the same as last time. It's very streamlined. You take this off, it's an airless pump, and then you're going to pump it out. Sometimes when you first get your product, you might have to pump it a couple times and then the product will start to pump. Sometimes there might be a little bit of air in here that is not allowing it to pump out. So basically, don't be alarmed, but this happens with all airless bottles. That happens with our face primer also. You just have to pump it a couple times. And remember too, if you are getting your face primer and you open it up and you're like, oh no, it's broken, there's no tube, it's an airless pump. There is no tube. That's the beauty of this. So this same thing, it might be on its side the whole time, you know, in shipping, and then you get it and it needs a little extra help to get it flowing, but that's the way it's supposed to come. All of my bottles have always been airless pumps. So I'm going to be using light, and I pump out about one pump. Sometimes I might do just like a quarter of a pump again, but this is enough for you. You don't need that much. If you put on too much, it's just going to be over dispensing the product or wasting the product. I'm going to take my foundation buffing brush and I just tap into the product. Start in the center of your face and then pull out. I usually, because I'm right-handed, start in this area and then I work it out to my hairline area and then up to my forehead. Now again, I designed this brush to be perfect around your eye and your hairline. I didn't want it to be too big because I can't get anything into my hair because you see it right away. I can't disguise it, and then it's a whole nother issue. So I wanted to have a buffing brush that was just perfect size. So I'm gonna go into, as I put this on, go into all of the details of what's in the product. So I created this BB cream to be a really lightweight enhancer, and it's a completely new look for my formulation. So it's going to be a semi-matte skin finish. That's what I really wanted for you. I didn't want wet, sticky, and shiny. I didn't think that was a really good look for mature skin. I wanted it to be hydrating, but yet still very elegant and very forgiving on the skin. So my new formula, it's going to be very comfortable wearing it during the day. It's a low to medium coverage, but it has visible results when you apply this, as you can see. So I enriched it with Kakadu Plum Active. Now this is a compound containing one of the highest sources of vitamin C. The texture is really beautiful. It's easy to apply. It remains fresh and it leaves the skin very toned and very hydrated. I also included shea butter in this, so it's going to nourish and protect your skin. It's really going to soften the skin also. I have emollient oils that are derived from coconut oil that leave it really silky and light. I also have vegetable squalene that improves cell renewal and helps the skin hydration. It gives us like the flexibility. And I also have hyaluronic acid in this to give you that moisturizing property and again, softness. So the Kakadu Plum, it's going to be a really powerful antioxidant. This is going to help stimulate collagen growth, reducing fine lines, wrinkles, skin redness, which is what I need, and improve skin hydration. So this is really important because we want that hydration in the skin. We want the skin to look plump, but we don't want it to look really greasy or like overdone or not feel comfortable. This is going to give you that natural finish. It's a weightless sensation. It's a semi soft matte finish, silky and light, and it's really flexible. So this is also clean beauty. It's fragrance free. It's cruelty free. It's made in Italy. And I really, really worked hard in this formula. And you've seen it over the last year on my channel and just really how beautiful it is. I mean, this is something that I look forward to putting on my skin because I know it's going to look really beautiful, but I don't feel like I'm wearing anything. I don't feel like I'm really weighted down and it doesn't, you know, it doesn't read right, whether it's on film or on pictures or in real life. It all looks very seamless and really beautiful. I'm absolutely so excited to hear your feedback because I know we've been waiting for this for so long. I'm going to use my Classic Beach Glow that also launches tomorrow. And this is a cream palette. So you have a cream blush, cream bronzer, and a cream highlighter. So lots of versatility for you, all in one compact. This is one of my favorites to use because I can literally do so much with this palette. I was traveling or I went on vacation and I really just wanted one palette for my complexion in the sense that I'm going to have so many different products that I can put on my eyes, I can highlight, I can just look really healthy. I am going to put a little bit of the highlighter just right here. You can see it's just like this beautiful glow. It's not glitter. I mean, it's just so beautiful. And then just, I'll get a little bronzer. I'm going to just move it up into my blush that I just did. Just that little bit gives you so much dimension. Just gives you more of that kind of glow, but yet not over the top. So this is definitely something in 2024 that's really adding something to my skin and looking very healthy. Okay, so just to finish it up, we gotta do the lips. So I'm gonna use my favorite Cameo. I want a little bit of color here on my lips. And so I'm going to use my waterproof Cameo lip liner. And then I just kind of work it into my lips to soften the line. I'm gonna just put a little rose balm on my lips prior to my lipstick. I'm going to use Pretty Smart since I'm wearing navy. It's a beautiful light pink, as you can see. Now I'm going to, I could actually put on Champs if I wanted to, but I'm going to put on a little Coco 13. This is coming back into stock. This is one of our most popular lip glosses, and it just kind of gives me that signature, you know, customized lip. Any combo that you do, you're creating your own signature when you do a lipstick and a lip gloss. I love doing that. Just create different options for yourself with what you have. Last thing is I'm gonna use my Nikita Banana because I want to set my under eyes. This is my brightening pressed powder, and this also has shea butter in it. I'm gonna use my powder brush and I'm going to just go right underneath my eyes, just setting. And then I'll put my hair down and then you have your look for the day. Now, this is so appropriate if you're wearing, like I'm wearing a sweatsuit. This doesn't look like I have full makeup on my skin. My skin's like covered and heavy and what have you. It's lightweight. It is so perfect for mature skin because I know by talking with my focus group and talking with the ladies over on Beauty Reinvented, which is my private Facebook group of about 20,000 now, that we're looking for something that's going to make us feel good, but also look good, but also be easy to use. We're tired of having to cover up everything. I want to see freckles. I don't want to see pigmentation completely eradicated. I want to see an even tone. I want to see pretty. But I don't want to see on mature women where it's like a mask and we feel like we have to cover up and it's not acceptable, whatever. Show your beauty. Show your face for every unique bit that it has. Everybody has a different story. Everybody has a different path. And that's what's so beautiful. And that my makeup line now that is complete, because we're launching the brow mascara also tomorrow, Classic Beach Glow that I changed to an all cream palette, our BB cream, and I have a couple special surprises coming out this year for you. But that really concludes. I did 61 products in 1 year. I reformulated, repackaged, redesigned, learned logistics, learned how to navigate so many different things. And it was funny, my designer, we were working on a project and we had so many of these in 2022 and 2023 where the subject of the email was stop production, stop printing. So I saw one, it was literally January 2nd. And I was like, oh my gosh, it is January 2nd. I texted her, I was like, it's January 2nd. We already have stop production, stop printing. It was so funny because it was like, oh my gosh, the drama can't start again. So we had so many of those things that happened. And, you know, we were just on a Zoom call and she had taken certain pictures when we had like backgrounds on a Zoom call of like Martians and, you know, just like trying to hold it together. And she's like, I said, when was that? She's like, October. I'm like, October 2023 or 2022? She's like, 22. She's like, that's when you look like you're about to give up. I was like, oh, that was a bad month for me. So it's just really, you know, when you see a product with anyone's line, anyone that is an entrepreneur bringing you just superior product, know that it's not an overnight, like, oh, I'm going to create a BB cream and I'm going to create a line. It's just going to come out. This doesn't happen. My key word that I put on my Instagram the other day was resilience. I took a picture of our marble that is our marble countertop. And it just reminded me like all of the different veins and all the dark areas of gray. I was like, this was my journey. All those dark grays is when I was like, what's happening? Am I able to do this? So many setbacks. And then like the jagged way of everything, you know, going, and then it came together. But the key word for me was resilience. Like if you don't have that in any path that you're working on, you don't have to be in cosmetics. You can be in any kind of career. There are going to be those dark times where, I mean, literally I was like, I mean, it was just, I would never want to go back to those spaces. And I've tried to not think about the journey of that, but then I'll go back and be like, wow, it's really important to really think about that, because I had to make the decision to keep going. I had to say to myself, why am I doing this? I'm doing this for mature women that don't really have a space in this beauty industry, don't have a voice, are not being heard or being told to do so many things to their face and to alter and to change. I'm so opposite of that. And so I kept thinking to myself, ladies need to have something that's amazing and it's created just for them. And I kept going, and you know, it was just, you know, I don't want to like get too emotional about it, but it was really, really a passion. If I wasn't into it 100 and 300%, I would have said, you know, it's not worth it, but it was worth it. And I'm here, and 61 products later, I did it. I really did it. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope this is, you know, something that enhances your life. And, you know, I'm just showing you that my volume up mascara is water resistant. So with that said, wow, I made it through 2023 without crying once on my channel. I don't think I did. No, I didn't. But we're going to start 2024 with happy tears and being so happy that I got through this. So ladies, thank you for supporting me. I'm always here for you. With my product, with my everything, and did my makeup, and then now look at it. So if I wasn't puffy before, we're puffy now. So ladies, thank you for being here. And until my next video, I'll see you later.